Now, former Speaker of Parliament Rebecca Kadaga is addressing some bygones. Now, she has broken her silence over the results of the speakership race months later, saying it was marred by corruption and intimidations. Now, this was the speakership race where she lost to her former deputy, Jacob Olanya. Kadaga assured the people of Busoga of continuous lobbying for the region. She made the remarks during her first public appearance in Busoga at Butagaya sub-county headquarters in Jinja District. We have the report.
Former Speaker of Parliament Rebecca Kadaga, now First Deputy Prime Minister and Minister of East African Affairs, was welcomed by huge ululations, cheers and Chisoga traditional dance at her first public appearance in Busoga sub-region ever since she was defeated by Jacob Olanya for speakership. Kadaga was in Butagaya sub-county headquarters in Jinja District to preside over the handover of an ambulance donated by Kagoma County Member of Parliament. At the occasion, Kadaga, who had never commented about the results of the speakership race, told the gathering that she was not defeated. Instead, she was cheated. Kadaga used the platform to assure the people of Busoga of government's takeover of Busoga University. She was furious about the political rivalry in Busoga. Stephen Kisa, Member of Parliament for Lucas South, who nominated Kadaga, vowed to continue fighting her counterparts at all costs since they still regard her as a pillar and champion of development in the region.
The Right Honorable Rebecca Itwala Kadaga has done so many things for Busoga and Uganda at large. There is no any other person we can support in Busoga here when we do not have Kadaga. When Kadaga is not there, Busoga is not there. That is why I said Right Honorable Itwala Kadaga is the mirror of Busoga and is the woman of Uganda. I'm basing on that one because of the many achievements for Busoga alone. The other day, the number of roads we have acquired in the Busoga region, it has been because of her effort. She has mentioned about the university because of her effort. She has mentioned so many things about because of her effort. So I want to pray, whoever fights her, we shall fight here.
The residents in the area expressed relief after getting the ambulance in their area, narrating various hardships they had been facing.
Yes, they've been facing is transportation. Getting border borders, arranging for border borders, calling for border borders to reach them very quickly has been a problem. Sometimes we refer them at night, whereby there are no transport means. So that causes problems to the outcome. For example, the outcome of labor. In case I'm referring a mother who has got a fetal distress, by the time they reach there, the baby will have got severe distress.
Referral cases at the facility are taken to Jinja Referral Hospital, which is about 10 kilometers away, which has been a great challenge to them. Story by Ivan Wachibi for the news in Jinja City.